Good morning, children. Today, I am going to discuss the theme Loss of Faith in God and Religion, expressed in Matthew Arnold's poem, Dover Beach. The main objective of this video is to help you understand the theme Loss of Faith in God and Religion, expressed by the poet Matthew Arnold in his poem, Dover Beach. So open your workbook Reverie at page number 129. Before discussing what the theme is, I will first discuss the difficult words in it. Underline them on your book and write meanings so that later you understand the theme in a better way. Now write down these meanings. Negation means saying no. Regret means to feel sorry. Validity means the state of being acceptable. Theological means religious. Percepts means rules. Postulates means assumptions. Perceived means regarded. Crumbling means decaying. Physician means a person skilled in the art of healing. English here refers to a person of England. Naturalist is a person who studies plants and animals. Consequently means as a result. Cast in means thrown. Lamented means cried over or moaned. Gleams means shines. Fades means becomes dim. Girdled means wrapped. Receding means declining or decaying. Waning means decreasing in quality. Desolate means lonely, joyless or sorrowful. Gradual means proceeding by steps. Ebbs away means fall apart from higher to lower level. Mournful means sad. Naked means without cover. Isolated means lonely or lonesome. Melancholy means sadness. Chilly means harsh. Stripped means exposed. And dreary means not cheerful. I would also advise you to read the poem again and again so that you can revise the text to later quote it in your answers for better scores. Now, let us read the theme, Loss of Faith in God and Religion. Matthew Arnold's Dover Beach expresses his regret at the loss of faith in God and religion. The validity of long-standing theological and moral percepts were challenged by scientific postulates. This means that, like many other people of Victorian era, the poet Matthew Arnold was also moved by Darwin's theory of evolution, and he has expressed this loss of faith in his poem, Dover Beach. Now coming back to text, in Arnold's world of the mid-1800s, the pillar of faith-supporting society was perceived as crumbling under the weight of scientific theories, such as those of English physician Erasmus, English naturalist Charles Darwin, and French naturalist Jean-Baptiste Lamarck. Consequently, the existence of God and the whole Christian scheme of things was cast in doubt. Here, Christian scheme means belief in Christianity, that we all are the children of God. Now come back to text. Arnold, who was deeply religious, lamented the dying of the light of faith, as symbolized by the light he sees on Dover Beach, on the coast of France, which gleams for a moment and fades away the next moment. Like the sea, faith, principally Christianity, once girdled the world like an attractive bright-colored scarf, tightly binding all together. Now,
However, the sea of faith is receding. The power of religion to give unity and meaning is waning, leaving behind only the cold wind whistling over the desolate beach. This poem expresses how the faith in God that once bound the whole world as one was decreasing and losing its meaning. Now coming back to text, the poet explains the gradual loss of man's faith in grand and suggestive simile. The poet has compared faith in religion to a sea that surrounds the world. The sea has its full tide, and then it ebbs away with the mournful music over the pebbles. The grating of the pebbles brings the eternal note of sadness in. The poet reminds of the time when people had faith in God and believed in religion. But now, that faith is gradually fading away and men's minds are like pebbles on the shore which become naked when the water recedes. Darwinism in Arnold's 19th century England brought science into full conflict with religion. Science challenged the percepts of theology. The poet refers to the idea of the world being covered in naked shingles. It means that when faith pulls away, it leaves nothing behind but sadness. The passing of faith causes the minds to be isolated in the border between belief and disbelief. It is a sad state. When the poet hears the grating roar of pebbles on the sea, he is reminded of the melancholy, long, withdrawing roar of faith as it retreats from men's minds. It is a chilly prospect, like the breath of the night wind, and it brings into the mind a dreary feeling of helplessness, as though the mind is left stripped and bare on the vast and dreary edges of an unknown land. This showcases the disturbed state of mind of the poet. The grating sound of pebbles remind him of the sadness that fills the minds of the human beings when their faith in God vanishes. Dover Beach provides bitter expression of Arnold's loss of faith and his growing pessimism. The world seemed to be strangely unreal, without anything real to cling to. It has variety, beauty, and freshness, but it is all blind negation. There is in it neither love, nor joy, nor light, nor peace. There is nothing certain in it. Therefore, he has compared men struggling in the world with armies struggling on a plain at night. There is a sound of confused alarms and struggles, but the soldiers are ignorant as to what they are fighting for and why. It is suggestive of the fact that when the light of faith in God and religion fades away, it results in a great sense of emptiness and hopelessness. Hence, in this way, the poet has clearly expressed the theme of loss of faith in God and religion in his poem Dover Beach. I hope you have understood the theme. Now, your homework for today is solve question number 1A given on page number 138 of your workbook, Reverie. Thank you.